Kitchen. Today we're making oven-barbecued chicken drumsticks. And I decided to make that because recently I uploaded basic barbecue sauce. And that was not my main barbecue sauce. I have a Betty's Own barbecue sauce that has probably five times as many ingredients. This one just has four ingredients. It's very simple. It has tomato sauce, it has brown sugar, it has steak sauce, and a little vinegar. And the purpose of it mainly is if you keep your pantry pretty well stocked and your refrigerator and so on, you might occasionally run out of barbecue sauce, but you might have the other things. You might have some tomato sauce in your pantry, you might have steak sauce in your refrigerator, and then also having the brown sugar is pretty common, and also having a little bit of vinegar will allow you to have a lovely sauce that looks like this. So I just call it basic barbecue sauce. But I wanted to use it on something to let you see how it turns out when something is actually cooked using it. Now the cooking will be done for these drumsticks without the sauce, but the final stages will have the sauce on and allow it to permeate the meat and give a good flavor, and it will maybe crisp up a little bit and look really nice at the end. But in order to get these drumsticks cooked, I'm going to do it in the oven using a broiler pan like this. And most of you that have watched me very long know that I do this every time. I cover the bottom with aluminum foil so that any drips I can just rip away and put in the garbage. And then I also cover this and take a knife and put the slits in, and that just makes for an easier cleanup. You still have to clean it, but it's easier. Now over here I have my chicken drumsticks, and there are 3.5 pounds, and these were huge. So that's going to mean that my cooking time might be longer than it normally would be. But what I'm going to do, or what I've already done over here, is to spray the top of the broiling pan. In my case, the aluminum foil that's sitting here has been sprayed with cooking oil spray. That's so these won't stick and I'll be able to turn them. I may need to turn them quite often during the cooking to get them cooked evenly. Now, what I want to do is to put them on and hopefully fit all of these on, and then I'll be going through with salt in a salt shaker, just regular salt, and pepper in a pepper shaker. And I will get the tops of them, I will wash my hands and turn them all over and get the other sides, and then this will go into an oven, and it's going to be set to broil. And we usually leave the oven door open. I think I'm going to leave it closed this time, and then at the end, if I need that broiler unit to be on for the whole time, then I might open that door. But I'm going to put it a little above the middle of the oven and then just turn it to broil and keep watching it. Keep watching and turning, and it probably will take about a half hour for the average drumstick to cook. But since I have 10 of these that are huge, I'm thinking maybe 45 minutes. But I'll keep track of the time and tell you what it is. So I'll come back when, maybe in the progress of getting these, looking at these in the oven. But I don't think you really need to watch me salt and pepper them. So I'll go ahead and do that and get them in the oven. These are the chicken drumsticks that I showed you just right in the oven after 30 minutes of cooking. And I would like to say that I did salt and pepper both sides, as I indicated I would, and I also gave them a good spray on the top each time. So, doesn't hurt to do that occasionally just to keep them nice and moist. These are not done, actually. If you were to cut into one of these, you would see some pink, and that's not good for chicken. You have to get it all the way done. But I have this barbecue sauce, our basic barbecue sauce, and I want that flavor to go into the chicken drumsticks. So I'm just going to sort of paint this on, and I'm not worried about putting this back and forth because we'll be using this up in the next day or so. But if you have quite a bit and you plan to use it for several things, then just take a portion of it, because you can see it doesn't take a lot to get that covered. I will be turning it over and getting the other side, and I will do all of them like that and then put them back in the oven, let them cook longer, and then I may even give them another coating of this if I feel like it's cooked in somewhat and needs to be recoated. Then it doesn't hurt to put more on. So I'll see you back probably when they're done. Here are the oven barbecued chicken drumsticks straight from the oven, so they're steaming hot. I want you to notice what they look like when they're done. You can turn them over and see there's still a lot of that good sauce that hasn't been crisp, but on the top it will turn crisp, and you can see over here it actually burns. That's why you don't want to put it on at the beginning. You want to cook these until they are pretty much cooked, and then you can start putting this sauce on. And what I did was to put them in the oven for 10 minutes with the sauce on both sides. And then I brought them out and put the sauce on both sides again and put it back in the oven. So when you're cooking them, if you don't have a broiler or don't have that setting, you can use bake, that's fine. If you have a broiler, then you might want to cook them from the top, and that way you can watch, and all the time you'll know how far along they are in their procedure. So I'm going to get one of these off the tray here. Actually, I want to put them on the serving plate, so I'll just pick one and put it over here and show you that we'll make some kind of arrangement, and I'll come back and show it to you. So here we have our dinner ready, and the star attraction is our oven barbecued chicken drumsticks. So I'm going to just pick out one of these and put it on my serving plate over here. And I've already taken a bowl and put some of the salad that we made earlier, so you'll find it in an earlier upload. It is a green pea salad. And you'll notice that it has pickle beets, and it also has some yellow squash, it has cucumber, it has some parsley, and I might have missed one thing in there, but that's pretty much it, with a nice little dressing. And then earlier today we made some scalloped potatoes. These are the old-fashioned variety. So this is what they look like. I've already served some just to show you the picture during that video, so look for my old-fashioned scalloped potatoes if you'd like to see how these are made. I'm going to get a nice serving that has some of that crusty topping to it and put it on my plate along with my chicken drumstick. Some of you told me that you'd like to see complete dinners again, because I used to do that all the time. I will try to do that when I can. Sometimes it just doesn't... what I'm fixing doesn't lend itself to doing that very well. It's just an entity on its own. But we'll see what we can do with that. I want to taste this for you. I'm just tasting the chicken because I've already tasted the potatoes and also the salad in other videos. And this is really messy, so you want to give everybody napkins, maybe paper napkins, because you'll ruin your nice linen napkins. But I don't normally use a steak knife to eat this, but I think I can give you the best view of it by cutting down through it. And I don't generally use this method for testing for doneness, because I know it allows the juice to seep out of there, and you don't want that. But we just want to see that it's done before we eat any of this. And you'll notice that the leg part or the drumstick part of the chicken is dark meat, so don't expect this to look like chicken breast meat. It's going to have a darker color, but it should have no pink. If it has pink showing or an oozy red look to it, you don't want to eat it yet. So just put it back in the oven right on that tray. But look how great that is. That's just wonderful. So I'm going to cut down and try to get some of the skin on the outside. I never eat chicken skin. almost never. But I'm going to taste it for you. I'm going to sacrifice here. I know it tastes great, but it got 2 doses of the barbecue sauce, and I think you'll enjoy that barbecue sauce because it's so easy to put together and say, I made this, if you want to be able to do that. But I highly recommend my own barbecue sauce. It's just called Betty's Own Barbecue Sauce in Betty's Kitchen. Here we go. Mmm. It's been a long time since I've had dark meat chicken. Forgot how good it was. And that sauce just sets it off. Yeah, I got a big piece. I don't think I would change anything about it. It's kind of a tart, sweet sauce. I don't think you would classify it as very, very sweet or very, very tart or smoky or anything like that. It's just a really good taste. Hope you like it.